Morning, guys. We have it's Thursday, the 4th of July. We have 15 days left until we're supposed to be test driving this thing before we head across Canada. We're just going to do a little walk around and an update. So yesterday we got tires on it. A lot of you guys are going to wonder why there's Blizzaks on it, because we're never driving one of these cars in the winter again, unlike the big block Chevelle, and I'm going to burn these puppies off. So they get pretty good traction. They're good in the rain. And anyway, that's why we're running winter tires in August, because I'm going to use these puppies up. Man, we're so far over budget, I can't afford new tires. No kidding. So yesterday, we finished up the suspension.
Yeah, I got a couple bolts. The back is all finished.
Yep.
The front, well, it's got to go for an alignment. So they'll put in the cotter keys.
They'll put in the cotter keys. We're just basically mocking it up so we can move it.
So we're putting all the headlight in, inner baffles, Cassidy blasted and painted those yesterday.
Now we're getting all the lower part of the front. Yep.
Put this one in. Want to get the fuel tank up and installed.
Yep, fuel tank up and installed. We've got our, hopefully our buddy Todd's coming back today. We're going to get the motor broke in, just picked up the oil filter.
For the windshields, we're going to start putting chrome on around the windows.
Phil from Rainbow Glass is showing up this morning so we can get a windshield in this puppy. I mean, it's come a long ways in the last 2 days. So yesterday, tore our hair out a bit, but we got the sway bar in, rear sway bar. Yep, our electrical guru buddy Steve from Wireworks is coming Monday. For the last 2 weeks, our wiring harness has been MIA, but yesterday it showed up. So we've got our wiring harness. Man, I can't. This color is mesmerizing. Wait till you guys see it in the sun. It's just unbelievable. It's a beautiful color. And young Cass is slaving away here very quietly. That means things are getting done. What's happening this morning, Cass?
Love box and ashtray. I'm gonna get those painted today.
Okay, we're gonna get those painted today.
Do you have anything
else that needs to go green? No. Do you want me to blast those again? I see they've been starting to surface.
Put them with sandpaper.
Sandpaper, give them
like,
a quick scuff.
Most of this is just like literally just dry rust water.
So yeah, okay. Yeah, because they have been blasted, but okay, yeah, we'll give them a touch up. So then everything else is going to go green. So we have the ashtray hanging there all alone. We've got the glove box. We've got the front cowl. And we have the lower splash guard, valance, whatever you want to call it.
I call it a bumper filler. That's what they call it now.
Okay, a bumper filler.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. Perfect. Thanks, Cass.
Is that the bumper filler?
Well, that's what, so
it's a gravel guard. It's a gravel guard.
Well, they used to call it a lower valance.
Yeah.
And now on new vehicles, they call it bumper filler.
Lower
and
nobody, valance goes below the bumper.
No, there's an upper valance and a lower valance.
Because it goes between.
Well, the Mopars have a gravel guard, but it bolts to the bumper. This just bolts to the body, so I'd say.
Square body Chevy, you have a little panel in between the bumper.
Yeah. There's a million names for it.
Anyway.
When you're doing estimates like the new term, it would be a bumper filler panel on new vehicles.
Who cares? Paint it.
Different. This is an old car.
Yeah, yes. I know, and nobody knows old terminology.
That's right. Anyway, we're going to paint them. We're going to paint them. And they're going to look just like this. Okay, guys, stay tuned. Oh, look at that. Like. Blair, as Avery would say, like sunlight reflecting off a rifle barrel in the morning.
Oh, come on. It just makes me smile. It's a happy color.
It is. It is a happy color. We're all pretty happy. Okay. Anyway, stay tuned, guys. That's the update.
Got an extension, and we'll try to angle in. A lot of times with these body bolts, they're very pointed, which is freaking awesome. So if you have some slight misalignment, you can get it started and then straighten it out. I will use the screwdriver first just to make sure I'm in the vicinity. Yeah, okay. I am. So, tied up the dope, and a little bit of finesse. Okay, and now that I got it in the hole, straighten out. Wow. So now we're going out to the Field of Screams to rob some parts. I already tried. They were seized up. Okay. Hoping that'll do it. Turned it back a bit. I need this piece here. Okay, it's working. All right. And now, these ones have nuts on them and they were turning. So, all right, looks successful. Now this is a nice 66 El Camino, but it has a 64 front clip sitting on it. And this is one that Mike wants to fix up because Connor's got a 66, so Mike said, well, this is an El Camino 66. Now that he likes the really wide tires, he's going, let's do this car and make sure that I can fit slightly wider tires on this than Connor can on his. I'm all for that, but there's a lot of cars to do first, but I think it's an excellent idea. It's a pretty rust-free El Camino. It's actually quite a nice car. When I first saw it, I didn't like it. But he made me have a really close look, and yeah, he was right. Just gotta sandblast this then in our little bead booth. Yeah, look at that. Yes. And I've already got the other pieces blasted and in. I think I'm going to have to come out here and take this grill off. This one is pretty freaking nice. I can't believe we're putting in a used grill. Anyhow, we are. So, back to the shop. Hey, our
new antenna column. Got to take this mounting plate off of the original column. You're going to have to spray that down and then take this rubber bushing off, put it on this column, do a measurement to make sure I get it in the right place. And then I can mount the steering column. And then we have new U-joints and double D shaft. I'll show you what that's all about when we get to it. For now, I got to get this apart. Doesn't really want to come apart. They never do. I am going to get a measuring tape just to double check the length of the columns. Okay, so you put in your shaft. This is great stuff. Now you see the shaft where it comes through? Don't do that. Bring it back flush. And then you have a set screw and another set screw. So you mark those two spots and then you pull this out and you drill in just so that the set screw, when you tighten it up, goes into a little dimple, very shallow. Now I need to go find a set screw so I can show you what they're all about. So here's the set screw, Allen head. So then, once I drill the shaft, and also I cut it to length, right? So I cut it to length. Then I mark and drill the two spots, and then I tighten up the set screw. When I'm really happy, and you tighten up the set screw, and then you tighten down the lock nut, right? Plus, we use a blue Loctite, which is, you can take it off without heat, but it's super difficult. So we Loctite these in, we have a dimple, so they're below surface, and then this is incredibly safe. These work great. I've been using them, most people have, for years. A hot rod for factory, whatever you're doing, this double D shaft and U-joints can solve a lot of problems. If you have a bunch of headers sticking out in the way, you can put a joint mounted off of the frame. You can go this way and then come over and back. Once you go over two U-joints, you need to mount a heim joint somewhere to steady the whole affair, and then get around whatever you're getting around and get back to here. That doesn't explain it too well, but these are an excellent system, and this is what we're going with. Now I'm gonna figure out the length. They always tell you, use a piece of broomstick before you start cutting up your double D shaft, because it's pretty easy to maybe figure wrong, and then you gotta go buy another chunk of double D shaft. So, just so I don't forget, I'm putting my set screw. Well, I'll just, no, I'm going to set it here on top of the body mount, there. So, I can go flush. You also have to sink these, but it's almost impossible when you only got two U-joints to mess that up. U-joints should be in line with each other. So this U-joint here, I've got the ears up. So this would be ears up as well, the long side. Anyhow, I'm gonna figure out my length here, get a felt marker, mark it and cut it off. So I've got the steering column mounted where I want. That's flush. I just run them flush. And I think that's the perfect length. Whoa, again, there's a piece of crap. Yes. So I'll cut it, chamfer the ends, make it smooth. Then I'll put it back in, I'll mark my two set screws, take it out again, drill it, put it back together, tighten it all up if I'm happy, take it all apart again, Loctite my set screws, lock her down, and it's good. Okay, up on the steering shaft out of the column, you can see where I tightened up my set screw, and I'm using that as my mark. Everything else I marked and drilled already. I'm gonna try to do this one in place. As always, highly optimistic. There, dimpled, even up here. I marked that with the set screw, right? So now, this bottom one sets up. The set screw goes right into that slot. So it's got a flat spot here too. I've got the steering box centered exactly, centered side to side. So, yes, I can slide this down loose. Put my, where are my two set screws? There we go. Whoop, gotta put the top one on too. Gotta make sure I got that lined up. One spline out, there we go. Take that right out to make sure I'm centered over my hole. Over my dimple, I'm too far. There, that's freaking perfect. Okay. And you know, I'm just gonna throw some black paint at this, degrease it, paint this. Next time you see me, I'll have it sitting in here tightening up set screws. Okay, the steering inclusion. Okay, everything's been dimpled, assembled, put together, taken apart, decked around with. And now, I have my blue Loctite, which means I can get the bolt out without using heat, which is important. The red Loctite, the permanent Loctite, is not that way. So just a couple drops. Ooh, that's a lot of drops. So I've lined up with my dimples so I can put these in, tighten them up, and lock them down. Never to come apart again. In the perfect world. All right. And set the lock nut. Okay. Now, let's go back the other way a bit. There we go. Cassidy's working on trunk, tail lights, all that stuff. Oh yeah. Shh. Okay. Lock it down. Okay. Same with the top one. We'll do that next. Okay. Here's some more good clean fun. Install new clips.
and try to make this eyebrow, as we call it. Oh, this is fun. Okay. And one way up here. Whoops. Why you so and so?
Oh my gosh. Don't hurt the orange car.
Okay.
So what are you doing?
I think those are 264 grills up there.
Sick.
Don't they look the same, perhaps?
They do. Don't.
Grant us the strength to continue.
Back it up a little bit.
I think that's a sports satellite there. Okay, Cass, come and put your foot there. Okay. I'm up here now. There, Cass.
If I move my foot, you're gonna slide. I just established that.
Okay, well then don't move your foot.
Well, I can't. You're only doing too many things here.
That one looks pretty good though.
Yeah.
Let's look, we'll leave the ladder here. We'll check that one first. Need be, we'll come up and get that one.
Yeah. Yeah, no, come
this
down.
This one looks really good too. Wow. I got them coming out of my ass. They're everywhere. 64 Chevelle
grills. Don't step on me.
Okay. Perfect. Thanks, Cass.
Here, take that.
Yeah, where's that steel wool?
I don't know.
This one's definitely better than what we were working with.
Yeah, that one's mint.
Well, about mint, but it's way better than what we got. That's pretty weird, eh, Cass? Two of them on the wall for the last 7 years.
Oh yeah, it's really weird that there's random car parts hanging on your wall for all of your different Chevelles.
See, definitely the same grill. See it?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, guys, you're gonna get to watch me polish it. It's got... okay. Get your mind out of the gutters. Yeah. Oh, I have to do it sitting down. This is a great job. Yeah. There we go. It was all dull before. Now it's nice and shiny and good to go in the car.
Okay. Drill.
Let's see.
So these moldings are on. That one I went whack, and it now fits a fender.
Nice.
Some would say it was bent, but it just fits the fender so nicely. So now I'm going to put the grill in this end, and then I guess we've got to do the adjusters.
Yeah.
Are you going to burn?
Yeah, I got the trunks, rubber, and everything, except for the block and the one piece of foam.
Okay.
Lawn.
Okay.
We're almost started already.
Then we have, we got to clean up the regulators for the doors.
I don't put them
in the quarters. I don't know if we should put them through the goop wash, goop washer or not. Put the strippings on. Yeah, some glass.
Do we have like heater box and stuff like that?
Well, we're waiting for a heater core. But that's something you can look at. It's sitting there. Probably needs to be cleaned up. That's a good point.
Run it through the sandblast?
I don't know if it's metal or is that... Maybe you just hit it with black or unless it's steel.
I think it's metal.
You know? We should probably take that motor out and order a new fan motor. You want a new fan motor, Mike?
I don't know. Does it all work?
Mm-hmm.
Even if it worked.
Yeah. Well, since we've had better luck with the old ones, a new one, and I can order one. We can test it, though, and then we have a spare.
Okay.
I'll order one. Is it going in now? Is that what you're saying?
Well, we're going to clean it up and paint it. So do we waste some time cleaning up and painting a 55-year-old freaking piece of crap? Or do we just do the heater box?
Well, set up a defrog, it might be a frosty window. Let me go on board, go see if they go over the spot. You got the heater cores here. I never checked to see if it's the right one, but there's a 50-50 chance. What is the heater motor? Is there a part number on it? Oh. Okay, we found the hood trim. It's got a little divot here right at the front. I don't know if you can see it or not, but I'm gonna try and get it out. There's a little one on the tip there too, but just gonna give her a polish and put her back on. That's what we got. That's what happens, guys. You get to the point where just, where do you stop? And we've gotta stop somewhere because we have to finish. It'd be nice if we had another 3 months to finish this, but we don't. We don't even have 3 weeks. Took the rad in today to get it recorded, so should have that next week.
Hmm.
We could get another inch. I don't think it comes out this way. No. Gotta go that way. So I'm thinking of a better. Let's see. Let's just see. Okay, guys, what we did, we took a screwdriver and then we pried up this spring piece. And now we've got access and we can try and maybe get some of that divot out, which would be nice just because. You gotta be so gentle. Fuck. I'd like to get this divot out, Blair. You got any ideas? Well, just it's inside this little thing.
Put something in the vise where you can just push down with the molding.
No, because it's inside. Like it's right in the tip of this thing. I'm gonna try with a piece of wood. I just don't want to make it worse, right? Just a little bit better. I mean, I don't want to dick with it too much because it's a pretty nice piece as it is. Clean. This side's a little mungy, but it's what we got, and that's what we're gonna use.
Okay. These super fancy custom lights Mike got to help him out at night are freaking awesome, but they don't fit in the back here. So I've already done one side. I'm gonna make this hole bigger. What's going on? Why like that? I don't know why it does that. Maybe I broke it. Okay. Let's see if I have achieved success. Yeah, man.
Camera running?
Yeah, it is.
I do not know how or why, but in the parts car there's one, and in Seacam City there's one and a pair of these.
No way. Really?
Really?
Well, how are they?
These are sets. There's a set because there's a left and a right.
Well, you see what I'm doing here. I mean,
hey, which side is that one?
Well, this one's got a bit of body mangle.
Okay, I think these ones are better.
Oh, yeah.
Have to retouch the paint here. Look, this is a set. See, because there's left and right.
You can't buy those?
I don't know. Well, we ain't getting. We got these ones. It's only four screws.
Yeah.
At least put them in, right?
Yeah.
I mean, they'll match the patina of the original grill.
Oh, yeah, they'll match the door handle perfectly, Mother.
Yes, did I detect a slight note of sarcasm there?
Yes, subtle. It wasn't intended. Malicious.
Yeah, I know. You just
exactly correct.
But, hey, it's like a wedding. Something old, something new, something borrowed.
No. That's not how we're supposed to do this.
Yeah, it is. It isn't. It isn't Russ Brothers. I love the patina.
Well, weddings only last 5 years.
Hey, just ask yourself, what would Chad do?
Well, actually,
he would probably polish these up.
He would fix these up.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah,
That's right.
You would.
So when we go visit him, we can say we learned from him. Chad, we fixed these up. Blair wanted to buy new ones.
Hey, now wait a minute. He's not wrong. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
This, everything about this has been done.
Yes.
Except door handles and freaking headlight doors.
And grill. And
freaking grill.
Yes. Call it my little idiosyncrasy. Here. So which one, which is top and which is bottom? Which one fits? One's got the...
See, this has the real deep. It's got to go over top. So this is the top. So that would be for over here.
Okay, well here, there's a few dings. See what it looks like. Just try it. Try it.
Looks like I'm body mangled, bent up, a piece of crap.
Perfect. Look at that. I'll let you pound that one top dent out just because I know it irritates you. That looks pretty good, no?
Yeah. Okay, you know what amazes me? I had no idea. Look at the freaking gaps around here where there's nothing.
I know. I noticed that.
Nothing. Yeah. I had no idea.
Yeah, me neither. That's why I thought, no, we're missing a piece. And then I went and looked.
Yeah, that's really surprising.
That's probably why they run cool. There's so much air flowing in there.
Yeah, I suppose.
It doesn't hurt.
What the hell happened? Freaking screws again. Screwdriver.
Okay, so these aren't that bad, where I think we can use them. When we go out east, we can probably buy some right off.
Well, you should really just put out notice that if anyone has some along the way, you'll buy them.
Yeah. Mint original. NOS still in the Chevy wrapper, eh? You never know, somebody somewhere does.
Or maybe Mr. Chad can sit there and show you how to properly restore those ones with
these.
They can look like new. I don't have much luck with that.
No, I am terrible at fixing.
Well, I mean, in my mind, it's patina or not. To do this mix of patina and...
Well, not patina, it's just what we have, right? We didn't have hinges, we bought one. I wanted to use the original door locks and you poo-pooed that, even though you can get a key cut.
Ah, shoot.
Actually, I did get keys cut. What?
Nothing. Everything is good. There.
Is that a there? Yeah, that's what I expected. That's what I thought. There. Was it there?
Yes.
Have you explained to the camera your there theory?
At some point along the line, I don't know if they showed it or not.
Yes. So what Blair does when he f***s up, instead of going or O or F-bomb, he goes there, like he did it on purpose.
Well, then nobody comes over to see what you did. If
that's
you
right.
go, oops, everyone goes, what'd you do?
Yeah.
But when you go there, everyone's like, well, okay, he nailed it again.
Yeah.
My friend Kim taught me that.
Yes.
Okay, that's only 2.5 hours to put in 4 headlights.
Good thing you're cheap.
Man.
Okay, so this one goes here like that. We could just touch up the paint.
Yeah, we need to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There.
I mean...
It goes there or goes under?
Goes over. I know how to go over top, man.
I don't know. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you're not taking out a grill to adjust your headlights.
Okay.
Right? It's riveted.
Oh, is it?
Okay. Well, yeah, right?
Well, so. It's got to go up to for the screw.
Yeah, there. Well, it doesn't fit.
Yeah.
Imagine that.
There. Or did you put it upside down?
Well, I might have. I don't think I did. But sure.
Because we checked it. Oh. I'll tell you right now, is there a hole here for this screw? Yes. Okay, it should be the right way. Then.
There's a cutout here for the hood latch.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, because there was a bigger one to clear here. The big piece went up. But yeah, but it should line up with those holes. That's okay. We're not taking it out. We're going to make it fit.
Yes.
I think if you had to do it the third time, you might lose your s***.
I bought 2 bags of rivets, just in case.
Oh, there you go. Practice makes perfect. You'll be the best rivet driller.
Oh, yeah.
Do we want to touch up this black paint or not?
Well, I think with a brush.
Yeah.
I couldn't find like a windshield plastic thing that I will put this in with, but I'm just going to use this paint stick and I'm going to wrap the end of it in tape so I don't mess anything up.
You're live. He said live is the Memorex. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can't switch this hose and run this. I can just fire it up and run it for 5 minutes anyway, just because we can. I just want to see if my hack still works.
There's no way I'm putting this rustable nuts on here. Now I gotta paint them.
Okay.
Let's see where this goes. Okay, it's together. I can play with this more if I would like to, but right now is not the time. Time for a front bumper. Okay, Cassidy laid out the bumper bolts. Get these dialed in.
What?
And bumper clip for the frame. These kits have everything. It's quite impressive. Whew. Get that in place.